Hello friends, let us now learn some important points about medullary carcinoma of thyroid. So what do you see in medullary carcinoma of thyroid? This medullary carcinoma of thyroid mainly arises from parafollicular C cells. Okay, these C cells are actually derived from ultimobronchial bodies. These C cells are derived from ultimobronchial bodies. Okay, these parafollicular C cells will produce calcitonin. So there is increased calcitonin is seen in medullary carcinoma of thyroid. So what are the types of medullary carcinoma of thyroid? We have two types of medullary carcinoma of thyroid. One, we have sporadic type. Second, we have MEN2A or MEN2B type. Okay, in sporadic type, it is seen in 80% of cases, whereas MEN2A and MEN2B is seen in 20% of cases. Sporadic patient is old and he has single or unilateral lesion with RET proto-oncogene mutation. Okay, whereas the patient with MEN2A and MEN2B developing medullary carcinoma of thyroid, it is seen in 20% and it is seen in younger patient, and the tumor will be multicentric and bilateral, and here also there will be RET proto-oncogene mutation is seen in MEN2A and MEN2B also. So if you see the clinical features, in the clinical features you will see presence of midline swelling. In the clinical features you will see presence of midline swelling in the anterior part of neck, and this midline swelling is actually associated with increased calcitonin. Okay, it is associated with increased carcinoembryonic antigen. This is also associated with diarrhea. Okay, there is amyloid stroma is seen, and here you will also see presence of positive family history of hyperparathyroidism. There can be positive family history, especially in MEN2 syndromes, or there can be positive family history to pheochromocytoma also. Okay, now what about the routes of spread in medullary carcinoma of thyroid? It spreads to either hematogenous route or it spreads via the lymphatic route. Okay, now what is the most common site of metastasis? Most common site of metastasis is the liver. Liver is the most common site of metastasis. This tumor is a TSH independent tumor. Because it is a TSH independent tumor, in the tumor, if you see, there is no uptake of radioactive iodine. There is no uptake of radioactive iodine. Why? Because in the follicle, there is no sodium iodide. Symporter is completely absent in the follicle. So, as a result, there is no uptake of the radioactive iodine. So, as a result, radioactive iodine ablation is not used. Then, if you see in thyroid malignancy, chemotherapy will have very limited role. In thyroid malignancy, the chemotherapy has very limited role. Now, if you see investigation of choice, the investigation of choice for medullary carcinoma of thyroid is we do FNAC, and if you see the treatment options, treatment of medullary carcinoma of thyroid, you should do total thyroidectomy is done along with the removal of, because it can go through lymphatic group, you will have to remove the central group of lymph nodes. Removal of central group of lymph nodes is done, or You can also do routine central lymph node dissection can be done. Plus or minus ipsilateral modified radical neck dissection can be done if tumor is more than 1 cm. Or you can also do bilateral neck dissection can also be done. We can also do bilateral modified radical neck dissection is done if any lymph node is positive. So if you see the prognosis of medullary carcinoma is poor and it does not take radioactive iodine. Okay, so this is about the medullary carcinoma of thyroid. Thank you for watching.